Anthony F. Elmore, President and Founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, here today to bring you in another exciting Black Buddhist Lectures. We at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are not only the Black Buddhist Force in America, we are the Black Buddhist Force in the world, and we are the only Black Buddhist organization in the world that do not have Asian Buddhist masters. When we learn that the Asians educated all Black history, culture, and language from the Buddhist teachings, we educated them out as our teachers. Now, today we're going to bring you an exciting Buddhist lecture. My lecture today is Nichiren in the Ancient Japanese were Black People. We practice Nichiren Buddhism. What is not known by most Black people is that Nichiren in the ancient Japanese were Black people. The Chandala were the Black oppressed people of India. Now, you must understand that Japanese history too is also Black history. But what is happening is that the Japanese do not tell you that the original people of Japan were Black people, and many Black people were a part of Japanese history, culture, and the language. Now, in 1923, this is in regards to Japan, anthropologist Roland B. Dixon wrote that, quote, the earliest population of Japan were in the main blend of proto-Australoid and proto-Negroid types, and thus similar in the ancient underlying stratum of the population, south along the whole coast throughout Indochina and beyond India itself, unquote. See, Dixon pointed out that in Japan, the ancient Negro, a Negrito element, may still be discerned by characteristics which are in the same exterior and ulti logic. Now, do not take the words of Anthony F. Elmore. I want you to please view a YouTube video that was put together and uploaded by Japanese scientists that tells you about the Black history of Japan. Now, I learned Buddhism from the Japanese sects Nichiren Choshu, Nichiren Shu, and the SGI. And these Japanese purposely and maliciously extricate all Black history, language, and culture from Buddhism, and they do not tell you about your Black Buddhist history. Let's first of all take a look at the video that clearly and empirically proves that the Black history and culture of early Japan. Japan was a part of Black history and culture as well. The people of Japan today are not the people of ancient Japan. And by today's standards, Nichiren Shonin is considered Black. I want you to look at the picture of Nichiren Shonin and the most accurate portrayal of him, and you would find he does not look like today's Japanese. Let's first of all, let's look at this video that the Japanese produced and come back and put a period on this lecture. Let's look at the video and come back and put a closure on this.
では、日本人の祖先はアフリカからどのようにして日本列島にやってきたのでしょうか。私たちの祖先の一部は中近東を経てヨーロッパに渡る集団と分かれアジアに移動しました。人々は移り住んだ土地の環境によって白人、黒人、黄色人種という特徴を獲得していきました。気候風土の違いの大きいアジア大陸ではモンゴロイドも多様に変化していきました。その中に1万2000年前に日本列島に移動し 縄文の文化を築いた集団がいたのです。それからさらに1万年後、別の集団が再び日本列島に渡ってきました。蓬莱博士はさらに東アジアの5つの集団のミトコンドリア DNA を分析し、日本人の成り立ちを調べました。その結果は思いがけないものでした。蓬莱博士によると、本州の日本人では日本人固有のタイプはわずかに 4.8% しかありませんでした。それに対して韓国人や中国人と共通の配列を持つ人がおよそ 50% にも達することが分かりました。さらにアイヌや沖縄と共通のタイプを持つ人が4分の1もおり、多様な集団で成り立つことが判明したのです。一方、韓国人では韓国人に固有の配列は 40%、 中国人では 60% もありました。
本州の人たちというのは、その遺伝的にあまりその特徴がなくて、むしろ大陸というか中国とか韓国人のそういう特徴が非常に多く含まれるということが分かったわけです。決してその遺伝的に均一な集団ではないということが分かったわけです。
アジア大陸から日本列島に渡ってきたモンゴロイド、これまで一つだと思われてきた縄文人、一つだと思われてきた弥生人も、実はそれぞれ多様な集団だったのです。
現代の日本人は決して単一な集団ではなく、中国大陸や朝鮮半島の人々と深いつながりを持っていることが分かりました。しかも日本人のルーツは縄文か弥生かという単純なものではありませんでした。こうしてミトコンドリア DNA を手がかりに人類の設計図をたどってみると、当然のことながら人種の区別や国家による国境などは全く見えません。そこに見えるのは大自然の一員として生きている人という存在だけなのです
。 You saw the video that tells you empirically that black people was a part of the ancient Japanese culture and history. The demographics of the population changed in Japan. The Japanese who we see today are not the Japanese of old.When you look back at Japanese history and culture, you will find that black people were very much an intricate part of Japanese history and culture, and they're not like the Japanese of today who purposely extricate all black history, culture, and language from the Buddhist teachings.
There you got it. Not only was Nichiren black, the ancient Japanese population come from black people. Anyway, I am Anthony F. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association. Thank you very much.
All ancient icons show a simple fact. They all show that the Buddha was black. I believe in facts and Cato was wrong. Buddha was no Aryan. This song saw the history by those who rewrite history.Brothers and sisters, there's something to understand. It was 1,000 years after Buddha's death, his teaching right in Japan. Let me tell you something that makes sense. The Buddha's teachings did not start in the Orient. Those of you make a religious decision, the Buddha's teaching no ancient religion. The Buddha's religion has a lot of mysteries.